Melee is so much harder for me than magic. Chainmail again. All right, I'm not gonna complain about that. Guardian Spirit again. All right, things are looking up now. Hopefully, I find a Ring of Mana to take advantage of these Guardian Spirits. I don't like Guardian Spirit on the vast majority of my characters, but this character will not really be casting spells, so Guardian Spirit is not really gonna be a bad thing for my character to use. In fact, it's gonna be a pretty good thing for these very early stages of the game, where you can sometimes spontaneously explode upon taking a bad fight. Jeeva! Oh boy, this is gonna be interesting. Oh boy, I don't know how to feel about this. Yeah, I got Jeeva from a Fated Altar on D1. I was like, should I do it? I see, I don't normally do Fated Altar on D1 because I please, thank you. Dexterity. Am I done? I'm not done. Okay, let me actually finish clearing this. I don't normally go Fated Altar because I normally play mages, and mages are really, really bad for going Fated Altar. But on a melee character, it's a bit more permissive. If you get something really bad, you can just abandon. And if you get Throg, your character is still able to function. It might still even be able to function much better than before. So yeah, the only issue is that I got Jeeva on D1. And that means that I'm most likely not gonna find any scrolls of blinking. But on the other hand, I am a Phormizid, so that means that I don't really have any use for those. So that's the greatest downside of going Jeeva already neutralized. Jeeva doesn't really offer many defensive options. It only offers defense through overwhelming offense, via like Slimify and the Frozen Ramparts-like ability that you get from Jeeva, that yeah, Oozmancy, pretty good ability. The Jeeva abilities don't scale with invocations. That's also pretty good. That means that I'll be able to use them without having to train the skill. And yeah, this is just gonna kill many things. The radius of the effect is much larger than the one of Frozen Ramparts. You can move while it is active. It's a really strong ability. And it, of course, has acid damage. So that's also a big part of the ability, that it's acid damage, not ice damage. I don't know if it ignores armor like Frozen Ramparts does, but it certainly ignores evasion. So Jeeva gives exploration-based piety, and Jeeva also gives incredible amounts of exploration-based piety. It's like the piety gain on Jeeva is much, much faster than on other gods. Yeah, because you're not supposed to have Jeeva on D3. So now I have 4 pips of piety on Jeeva on D3, and I have 1.43 HP regen per turn and half a mana per turn. And that's just glorious. This is gonna be a fantastic game if it goes for long. Is it exploration, or is it from jellies eating items on the ground? For old Jeeva, it was from jellies eating items off the ground. But now, current Jeeva likes it when you explore the world outside of the slime pits. That's all that Jeeva cares about now. The jellies eating your items is an unfortunate downside. A conduct of that, you know, like a conduct. Ooh, ho, jeez. I am very compelled to take that double sword. Not gonna lie, I want to go for a great sword, but double sword is gonna be a nice stepping stone. On the other hand, I am compelled also to grab the gold, because as a Jeeva worshiper, I won't have a lot of that. Jellies are just gonna get to it before I can. I'm gonna get the double sword. Yeah, like it's crazy to even be considering getting 500 gold over a double sword. Yeah, goodbye, Falchion. I'm gonna train this to 16. This means delay for the double sword. Lajatango speed is a great weapon, dude. Lajatango speed is, oh, Manual of Long Blades. The boots are also really good. Oh, this is such a good acquirement. Even the gold is good. I cannot believe it. No, normally your acquirements are trash. That's common for your acquirements to have zero or one items or one options that you would like to grab. This one has four. Like, if any one of those appeared on an acquirement, I would be very happy. And this one has four items that I would love to grab. Yeah, this acquirement is something else. Jiva, two scrolls of acquirement, one of which gave me a double sword. The other one, I think I'm gonna go for the boots because res securing resistance to electricity is very important. The manual could be fantastic, of course, but I think it's more important to have resistance to electricity. You're gonna play an Ogre Necromancer of Kiku to prove a point? We'll tell you when I win. Sure, let me know when you win that. Good luck with that. I am waiting for the necromancy rework. Dude, I've been waiting 10 years for the necromancy rework. I'm gonna put it like that. I'm gonna get the boots. Yeah, because securing resistance to electricity is very important. All right, two scrolls of acquirement. First scroll that I read in the game was a scroll of acquirement, and then I find identify. I obviously want magic mapping here. Your stasis prevents you from teleporting. Okay. Wanted magic mapping for that ossuary, but I think we are really close to it. It would be tragic for me to die to that guy, but I don't think I'm gonna die to that guy. I feel like I just walk forward, accidentally rampage, Oozmancy, walk away, walk away. Yeah, just stab that guy. You barely miss, by the way. So yeah, that's why I didn't want to tab it. I feel like if I have tabbed it, I would have died in like two attacks. Amulet of Faith. Amulet of Faith. Amulet of Faith. I think I'm gonna drop the boots. I don't think I can see myself wearing them for the rest of the game. I'll put it on. Yeah, I'll put it on. Jiva's gonna like that, and I'm losing 6 HP, so it very clearly doesn't matter. I don't know where the ossuary is. I think it was over here. Knolls. I feel incredibly strong. Yeah, I guess that's what happens when you have like double sword of electrocution and 1.43 regen on D4. It's just natural that I feel so ridiculously strong. This character is gonna be good. Yeah. I feel like I already got past the point where there was uncertainty in whether or not I was gonna live. I feel like a juggernaut now. Now, what could kill me is overconfidence. That definitely could be the case. Wow, I don't like this layout for the ossuary. Yeah, this triangular layout is not something that I'm too much of a fan of. Okay. Jiva gurgles merrily, and a slime was generated, a jelly. What is going on? There's so many guys in here. Oh, the jelly saved my loot. That sucks. Well, I did that for nothing other than very slight amounts of experience. Did I get mutations from Jiva? Oh, yeah, I did get mutations from Jiva. I got four armor class. Yeah, I got nothing thanks to Jiva. Yeah, you know, sometimes you get good stuff from Jiva, sometimes you don't get good stuff from Jiva. Whoa, I got 3 pips of willpower from Jiva. Let's go. Oh, and I also got the retaliatory freezing. That mutation used to be a demon spawn only mutation. I think it got nerfed a bit when it was made into a mutation that you could just get. This is of course really good for a melee character. I would prefer to, have more armor class. Oh wow, I got 3-floor shaft. I feel strong enough that I don't die to the 3-floor shaft, but of course would have preferred to not get shafted for 3 floors. I saw an angel and I was like, not too threatened. Like I saw the halo and I knew that it was gonna be inside glass because at this point in the game, angels just straight up don't generate. How expensive it is? Ah, it's not that expensive. I'm gonna use it. Yeah, just to play it safe. You got 2 shot by one of us at Jeebus, but you would have as well. No Kiku, so it doesn't count. I would have, but I also wouldn't have fought EG with a Wand of Acid. In general, I try not to fight EG. Many uniques, you are better off just not fighting for like the longest time. What is that? You can eat it. Not gonna use that. I need to find the upstairs. I hope that the jellies don't eat my items while I'm out, while I am off these levels. Oh, there's some gold. I need that gold. I need those items. Yeah, I want to pick up as many items as possible before the jellies get to them. I assume that I'm gonna not get a ton of scrolls of enchant weapon. Because that's just the nature of being a worshiper of Jiba. What did you just eat? Oh. It ate a scroll, but it was an unlabeled scroll. Considering that I already found acquirement and an enchant weapon, I don't think I care too much about the rest of the scrolls. Yeah, those are the two most important scrolls for me to find. Yeah, Jelly is constantly eating items hurts. It hurts to see because it's very early in the game. Having slang sounds a lot like having dogs. What did you just eat? Yeah, but it's not normally when you ask a dog that, you ask it because you're worried about the dog's well-being, but as a Jiba worshipper, it's not like that. You really do wonder, why did I just lose permanently because I was a Jiba worshipper? I would appreciate not dying here. I definitely would, but I don't know if I can guarantee that. The Azure Jelly helped. Yeah, the Azure Jelly is gonna kill that guy. Okay, I'm also regening really, really fast, so I'm fine. That was very embarrassing, however. I am overestimating my power. I should go back to. No, I think this is the level what I was in, like the level what I should be. I'm gonna train this to 12, actually. 12 should be enough. And after that, I'm gonna train like 12 fighting. Still looking forward to my great sword. On the vast majority of characters, I would be okay with just staying with this double sword and a shield. But the whole point of being a Formicide is that you get access to using two-handed weapons and a shield. Lost a bit of my willpower. That means that I'm probably gonna lose all of it, because that's how Jiba mutations work. Jiba will tend to give you all the tiers of the mutation. And then when Jiba removes a tier of the mutation, that's like usually a prelude to you losing all the tiers of the mutation. That's not what I wanted to see. That brown ugly thing is really bad. It's on D6, like that's not survivable. Many characters wouldn't be able to survive that, so I'm just gonna leave. Okay, Ogre corroded. Someone got into a fight with a jelly. Okay, 12 long blades. Now 12 fighting, as I mentioned, 12 fighting. In my tutorial series videos, I always type in that the first thing that you should train always is the thing that you're using to kill things. And after that, you should train the thing that you're using to not die to things. In this case, the thing that I'm using to kill things is Long blades, right? Now that I have long blades at a reasonable skill level, I am training the thing that I'm using to not die to things, which is fighting. There we go. I cannot wear hats? Huh, I feel scammed. I was under the impression that I was gonna be able to wear a hat. That's why I fought that guy. But it's okay. Gasomnok hit me pretty hard and made me spawn some jellies, which then proceeded to kill that two-headed ogre. That was very convenient. Two-headed ogre wandered next to you along a corner. Yeah, attacks of opportunity. Dude, I insist that attacks of opportunity are too much of change in the game for the game to like accept it. Ideally, it would have never made it into the game the way that it is. I feel like something as drastic as the attacks of opportunity have been need to come alongside a massive rework of what the game has. But yeah, that's probably never gonna happen. The 400 turns after you followed Kiku. See? It's very clear that in this situation you died because you went Kiku. I wouldn't have died because I wouldn't have gone Kiku, right? Haha. Also, D4 two-headed ogre is pretty messed up. Great mace, but no great sword. No, talking about Kiku. But no, we're going Jiba. I don't have any plans to not be Jiba. I don't have any plans to leave Jiba, is what I meant. Okay. I have no poison resistance. So that Hornet was slightly scary. And then I remembered that I am a Phormesis, and I don't have to fear getting paralyzed by a Hornet. That's definitely nice. That's something that I could get used to. Phormesis don't need that much willpower. Willpower is pretty good for a Phormesis, still. It can prevent confusion, but that's pretty much it. It doesn't. It do, you don't have to fear getting paralyzed, so you don't really need to resist it. Oh, great sword. Okay, there we go. That's a great sword. I'm gonna be using that. I need a shield. I have a buckler on D9. I just found it. What is it? Am I seeing it? I am seeing it. Okay, let me go pick it up. Better secure it before those jellies get to it. I wish I had might here. I think I know about it. And if I know about it, I know that I'm not carrying it. Potions. No, I don't know about the potion of might, so that means that I may be carrying one. Let's find out. Mutation. Your skin warms up. Did I lose cold resistance? It's okay. Jiba will provide me with some fantastic mutations because that's what Jiba does. I like the rework of Jiba. It's a really, really good rework. And there we go, potion of might. Now I can fight. You shudder from the blow and a jelly pops out. Okay, that's pretty good. Quicksilverus will proceed to absolutely dumpster the Tengu warrior. And if it doesn't, that would be weird. Okay, give me that. It's gonna be my weapon from now on. Imagine telling 2021 me that you would be praising Jiba mutations. Yeah, that's right. But Jiba's rework was a slam dunk. Really, really good. I'm a big fan of the Jiba rework. If only the Dread rework had been like this. This one appeals much more to my desires as a player too, like what I'm looking for in a goth. By the way, I'm only doing this bolt that is obviously an awful bolt because I want to get to the loot before the jellies get to it. But I think at this point it's a bit too late and I should probably not keep pushing it because that's just gonna get me killed. Anyway, this great sword of draining is probably gonna be my endgame weapon. I'm gonna hold on to enchanting it for a bit longer. I think by the time I go into lure, I am gonna think about starting to enchant it. It's not like I have that many scrolls of enchant weapon anyway. If I had like seven, I feel like I would be less reluctant to enchant it. But I, of course, will never have seven scrolls of enchant weapon because I am a worshiper of Jiva. So yeah, going Jiva from the very beginning of the game. Scroll of Poison. Okay, I guess we're just gonna have to wait. Let the jelly seed everything. I am carrying Curare, unfortunately for you, Mr. Two-Headed Ogre, so I can just hit you with Curare. And then hit you with the sword. No, it's hitting my Curare. No, my Curare, dude. I have two darts of Curare, now I have zero. Dude, it's okay. Okay, you want to know why it is okay? Because the things that will get affected by Curare will also absolutely get dumpstered by Slimify. So yeah, in any situation where I would want to Curare anything, I could also Slimify it. So in that regard, I'm not so hurt by the loss of all my Curare. Okay, lost one peep of willpower. You have great hidden genetic potential. Sweet. Yeah, Mr. Two-Headed Ogre. Okay. I failed to take something into account is that and that is that when you're using long blades, you're gonna chop off Hydra heads, which is awful. Oh, you know what? I'm just gonna use Slimify on this Hydra. Yeah, all right, let's do this. Aha, it turns into an Azure Jelly. All right. I couldn't care any less about the potion of mutation. Yeah, for once I don't care about losing a potion of mutation thanks to the grace of Jiva. I should probably stop training long blades now that I have it at 14. Let's go ahead and train shields. I'm gonna train like 15 shields in anticipation to eventually finding a kite shield would be nice. I think being a Formicide, I do want to have 27 shields, so I would not complain about finding. Oh, I would not complain about finding those. Let's go. Now let's find 570 gold. Hello, Will Tarquine. Good to see you around. Kiku will kick you out of the game. Okay, that's pretty funny. Yeah, let's go. Okay, I'm using that. Hello, Gauntlets of War. Oh, Falchion of Flaming as well. I wish I had money. I would love to buy that for Hydra Bane purposes. Probably gonna go into Orc to try to get the money in Orc. I only need like 200 gold to be able to buy the Gauntlets of War, and of course the Gauntlets of War are like the most insane item that I could have gotten on a melee character. Poison resistance, that's nice. Herald. I got netted. Not that much of an issue, fortunately. Herald had a potion of haste. You know, if you're gonna do that kind of cheating, I can also use my Jiva abilities to kill you. Oh, Morris as well. That jelly really wants to eat that. No, leave that alone. That's mine. Oh, wait. Oh, I think I left behind like. No. Oh, okay. Morris stole some of my gear, but I picked it up immediately. I didn't even notice. I think that's what was happening. Morris steals your double sword of electrocution. Let's put this on. I was just trying to be optimal. I guess it's fine that that guy used a potion of haste because it's not like I'm losing anything. Okay, more loot. Spike leather armor. That can stay in the floor for a bit. It's definitely a low priority thing for me to pick up since the jellies won't eat it because it's an artifact and jellies don't eat artifacts. It's trash. Shall be left on the floor. 447. I need like 100 more gold to be able to get my Gauntlets of War. And then Gauntlets of War. Hey, the 11 Skeletal Warrior is kind of mean. Very difficult to kill. I can slimy fight because it's a corporeal undeath. I don't know if I really want to. I feel like it's very expensive. Maybe I should search for some of my jellies to hopefully hit the Skeletal Warrior. Well, I guess they're not my jellies, they're neutral. Yeah, I can displace them to gain ground on the Skeletal Warrior, which is nice. Hey, look at that! Skeletal Warrior is destroyed. I don't know if I gained any experience from that, but I'll take it. Found some boots. I have boots already, so I couldn't care less. I'm gonna use Acid on this Skeletal Warrior. I'm gonna use Oozmancy on this Skeletal Warrior, yeah. These Skeletal Warriors, because now that I've used Oozmancy, I shouldn't really have that many issues dealing with these guys. Plus three Scimitar. Oh, the boots. Well, I guess it's okay because I don't care about those boots. I care more about getting the 110 gold that I need to buy the Gauntlets of War. I have two options here. I can buy the Falchion and then not have to slimify every Hydra that I see, or I can try to hold on to my money and buy the Gauntlets of War. So I don't have to wait forever for the Gauntlets of War. Normally I would be confident that I would get 570 gold before too long, you know? Maybe after Lair and Orc I would have that amount of money. But considering that I'm with Jiba, Jiba just eats all my money. So yeah, the Gauntlets of War are a much more important thing for me to get. Let's go to Orc. Replaces every item that generates on the floor with a bit of money. So it's just a matter of going here. Scroll of Poison. I have Poison Resistance, right? Yeah, Scroll of Poison to get rid of these guys fast. Unfortunately, Scroll of Poison doesn't place the Clouds of Poison on the monsters that are like... it doesn't place clouds on monsters. It's like the Sea of Flames ability from Ignis. It is slightly better because the clouds are placed immediately instead of waiting one turn for the clouds. Phantom teleported you next to Sigmund, who you hadn't noticed was there. That sounds like you're not having a pretty good time with your ogre attempts. I hope that you have some better luck with that. And there we go. I got all that I ever intended to get here. Let's get out and let's buy the Gauntlets of War. Let's put them on. First gloves that I found in the game, and they are the Gauntlets of War. I'm fully geared out now. Pretty good resistances. The only thing that I would like to have is a Scarf of Resistance, because I don't have those fire and cold resistances. Therefore, it would be a nice item for me to have. Five Slaying, of course, wonderful. Oh, a better shield too. Better shield would be nice. Probably should stop training that for now. Train armor. Right, let's go do Lair. Your hidden genetic potential wanes. Your hidden genetic potential grows. You begin to heal more quickly. Times two, you begin... Dude! How much regen do I have? Look at that, dude! I have so much regen! That's because I'm using an Amulet of Fate, by the way. Not dead yet, but you should have gone Behemoth. Yes, in any situation where you want to go Kiku, go Behemoth instead, because Behemoth will give you better spells. It used to be that back in the day, what Kiku gave you was really, really busted. But now, now it's just better to go Behemoth. Mm. This is going pretty well. Sonya has distortion. Amazing. Corpse rot and sublimation of blood. Yeah, I told you. Back then it was like, oh yeah, my first book gave me full screen agony. And full screen agony is a pretty good spell, you know? But such a thing no longer exists. Kiku has been getting pretty hurt by the nerfs to necromancy. Okay, don't hurt me. I'm gonna try to paralyze you. Please cooperate. Okay, she didn't cooperate, but at least I didn't get banished. I'm gonna try to paralyze you. Please get paralyzed. Thank you. Alright, now I have Curare again. Only two darts, but it's fine. I'm gonna try not to waste them this time, like I did before. Three heal wounds is also nice. Box of beasts, pretty good thing. What is that, by the way? Oh, it's an Orb of Wrath, right? Yeah. It's just that the tile for the orbs, or like the glyph for the orb, is the same color as the glyph for a scarf or a cloak. So that's why I got confused. Yeah, I'm really expecting Kiku to get reworked. I got zombie hands, but I'm not going for spells this game. No, it ate something. I don't know what it ate, but it ate something that I could have gotten myself. You know, I'm also a worshiper of Jiva. I also want to consume by having things in my inventory. All these jellies are so selfish, leaving all those items, or hoarding all the items to themselves. Dude, I cannot believe this. This is actually the craziest thing ever. I have four regen on layer two. Like, I can get hit for like 40 damage, and I would regen that so fast. Not only that, but I'm also hitting really, really hard because I have this greatsword. My rate of healing slows. It's okay. I still have two stacks of that. Don't. Oh, it's a Rand'art. Oh, so it's not gonna eat it. It's good. It's really good. All right. I don't care about the strength, and I care about the dexterity. So give me that. I also care about the 2 pips of fire resistance. That's a pretty good ring. The ring of min-maxing. Obviously, the 9 intelligence would be better on a character that does care about casting spells. But even disregarding that, that's still a pretty good ring. Oh boy, this character is just insane. Did you see that? That was crazy. And for you, I have Oozmanzi. No, I have Slimeify. I need 5 mana for that. I'm gonna have to train a bit of spell casting then, so I can have 5 mana. I'll train it to like 3. I'll take off the ring. Okay, now I have 5 mana. Slimeify. Hit the Hydra. Hit the Hydra. Liquefies into an acid bluff. My hands burn. My hands shouldn't burn from doing that. But sure. I found Spider. That's always a tragedy. Falchion of Holy Wrath. I don't think I care. You know, I have a pretty decent stack of consumables, considering that I've been a worshiper of Jiva since literally D1. Maybe not the most consumables, because after all, I do lack a bit in the scrolls department, especially like identifying them. Okay, I'm gonna go back to armor. Yeah, now I have 8 manas while my ring is equipped, so I can cast, or so I can use a Slimeify, and I won't have to take it off for dealing with Hydras again, which is pretty nice. With a bit of luck, I'm gonna get the third stack of the regen mutation. But yeah, the character is bonkers at this point in time. I didn't think that, or rather I suspected that putting on a ring of, or an amulet of faith with Jiba was gonna be good, but I was not expecting it to be this crazy good. Okay. Petrify from the basilisks. That's fine. Barely took any damage because I have a ton of regen. So these guys cannot really hurt me past my gargantuan 25 armor class plus regen. Okay. And my money's not dangerous at all. Really, really not dangerous at all for my character. Yeah, just take a look at that. Poor Amaemon. Normally, Amaemon can be scary, but not on layer 3 against a 25 armor class poison resistant dude wielding a greatsword of draining with 5 slaying and all these mutations, you know? Yeah, Jiba can be so good this time. Like, I've only played 2 Jiba games properly since the rework, but the two of them have been very memorable experiences because the two of them have gotten ridiculously strong. I assume that this one is gonna be even more so the case just because of how early I got Jiba, and I haven't really been struggling in terms of gear, which was my greatest worry when it came to Jiba. Of course, being a Formiseed, I don't have to worry about not having Scrolls of Blinking because they don't do anything for me anyway. My God does not really offer me an escape option, but it does make me so ridiculously strong that I probably won't need an escape option, which is also a respectable, you know, goal to achieve when you're a Formiseed. Wow, dude, like the damage is off the books. It's actually incredible how much damage I'm dealing with this guy. I have so many stats too. I have 4 strength, 2 intelligence, and 2 dexterity. What does this god do for you? He does everything. Jiba will gradually fill the dungeon with jellies, which will rapidly consume nearby items as well as slowly consuming items from elsewhere in the dungeon. As they spread slime across more of the dungeon, Jiba will grant followers increasingly rapid health and magic regeneration and will begin mutating them to better reflect Jiba's image. Followers will later become able to call forth acidic ooze from the walls of the dungeon and to turn monsters to slime with a touch. Jiba likes it when you explore the world outside of the slime pits. Jiba's powers are not affected by the invocation's skill. So, yeah, Oozmancy and Slimeifies. Oozmancy is like Frozen Ramparts, but you can move and it's acid damage instead of being the usual cold damage. And Slimeify, which is what I just used, pretty much hits any corporeal, any living or corporeal on that monster. If you hit it while you have the skill active, it turns the dude into a neutral slime, and very often it is a neutral high level slime. So even though it is not your ally, it will still fight monsters, and it can very easily take care of some really nasty stuff. Jiba also gives you mutations like this. You begin exuding ooze. What is that? Your melee attacks may engulf your foes in ooze. What does that do? Silence on enable. What? Your melee attacks may engulf living foes that are your size or smaller? And it silences? That's crazy. That's really strong. You have a small jelly attached to you that senses nearby items. You learn Jonathan's body deflects attacks for 3 armor class 3 evasion. That's not bad at all. Yeah, Jiba will just give you crazy amounts of good mutations. So the Jiba is ridiculously strong. That is compensated for by the fact that normally getting to Jiba is very difficult. There's a chance for an altar to Jiba to generate like right next to the entrance to slime, or you can get Jiba from a faded altar, or you can get the very rare Jiba temple. those are like the only ways to get Jiva. In this case, I got Jiva from a D1 Fated Altar that I got. And so far, it's been a blast. Yes, I will make a... every version, I'll make a new version of the tier lists. Every time a new version releases. For the last tier lists that I made in like December, I didn't make a new version when 0.28 released because I felt like not enough time had passed since the last time I made a tier list. But yeah, on around August, which is when the next version is gonna release, that's when I'm gonna do the next tier lists, and hopefully by that point there will already be a rework of Necromancy, so I feel compelled to do the background tier list as well. So fortunately I didn't stumble into many Hydras while doing this place. Yeah, while doing Lair, I mean. Hydras were the main reason why I wanted to buy that Falchion. Like, the sole reason why I wanted to buy that Falchion. Orb of Mayhem. That's trash for my character, right? Because I'm a melee character. So yeah, this character is so crazy strong, dude. Did you see that? Did you see that? That was just something else. I am going to train a lot of dodging as well. Yeah, because I'm going to be pumping a lot of dexterity. So dexterity helps my dodging, helps my shields, helps my long blades. That's why I wanted to try high dexterity long swords for Misith. That changed the game. Like, it's crazy. Like, I'm really not wording it properly there, but like, that change was a game changer. It's a change to the game that is a game changer, you know? But you know what I mean. It's like, it revolutionizes the game. It is 100 times more impactful than Riposte ever was. Because there's so many builds and like decisions that you can make with your characters now that that were just like much that are much more exciting than going for Riposte or not going for Riposte ever was. So yeah, big fan of that change as well. Yeah, in the current versions, there's some changes that I'm very positive towards, and there's some changes that I'm not so positive towards. But that's just the nature of things. You can never be happy about absolutely everything. That's just unrealistic. My character is so powerful that I didn't really feel like resting after dealing with that guy. It was a bit of a sketchy situation, but yeah, I'm really pretty strong right now. I have 2 scrolls of enchant weapon. Still looking forward to finding a +5 greatsword of a white. I don't think I found whites this run. I only don't find them when I actually want a weapon from them. But my depots found like 4 or 5 white bands. Unfortunate. I wish Skeletal Warriors also were like whites and also had crazy good weapons, but they are just very scary and very dangerous instead of having good loot and being very scary and very dangerous because they have good loot. Whoa! That's gotta be one of the best messages in the game, dude. You feel robust times 3? That's like something else. Let me take a screenshot of that. Yeah, that's gotta be one of the best messages that you can get in the game. Now I have the HP that I would have with a Nogger. But I also have 27 armor class. Yeah, the Jiva is an experience, definitely an experience. Wouldn't recommend it if you can use the Scrolls of Blinking to get Jiva on D1, but it's a wild ride to have Jiva on D1 and an Amulet of Faith too. How much regen do I have? Two per turn. It's respectable, especially considering that I have now 150 HP. Yeah, that's pretty good for sure. Let's go do more of orc. Yeah, and I am a monk. Being a monk was a big deal when it came to getting Jiva, because it pretty much immediately gave me the regen, which was a convenient thing to have. Okay. The only issue here, I need that jelly to die, yes. Now I'm gonna use Immolation. And I am going to follow up with one the basis. Even though I don't have a vocation skill, that gets the job done. Dexterity. Yeah, this spells dispel on the zombie hands that channel in Simulacrum. You're a real character. Yeah, congratulations on getting dispel on the zombie hands. I guess you will also use that channel in Simulacrum. I don't use those, but yeah, some people have expressed positive feelings towards those spells. Normally, I would be more afraid of an Ogre Mage, but not with this character. Oh, by the way, let me stop dying and fight this properly. Yeah, there we go. Now I can fight without being immediately about to die. Something important to remember is that even though I am so obscenely powerful, I can still die given that I make enough mistakes in a row. I feel like that's the fate of most scroll characters, no matter their power level. So yeah, it's important to not take a fight like the one that I was about to take earlier. Okay. The nature of my resistances is gonna fluctuate a lot because, unfortunately, that's just how it is with Jiba. Not much that I can do about it. I train this to 20 now. 20 is min delay for a greatsword, which is what I'm using. I would also like to get 27 shields, of course, and a tower shield, but I just haven't come across one of those. I'm using a lowly buckler right now. Though it is giving me 8 shields, so it's nice. Better than not having anything, for sure. Alright. I kind of want to buy these, but I'm gonna think about it. Probably I'm not gonna buy them. I like that chainmail somewhat. Just because it's +7, that's like the main thing about that chainmail, the fact that it is +7. If it was not +7, I wouldn't be so interested in it. I'm gonna think about it. It might be one of the best items that I get on this character, for real, just because it's +7. Putting that on would give me a ton of resistances, a ton of defenses. So I definitely do want that. And when it comes to the -9 mana, it would only be a matter of training spellcasting to like 8 or so. Wow, this character is so strong. This is actually so ridiculously powerful. Being a Formicide makes it so that I don't even have to fear monsters with hexes, or most monsters with hexes, I guess not all of them. Because, like, those orc sorcerers have paralyzed, the other mages have paralyzed, but I'm a Formicide and I cannot be paralyzed. So yeah, being a Formicide does have its small upsides. Etin? No, that's not something that I'm too interested in fighting in a fair fight. And by that I mean that I'm gonna use slimy fight and turn it into a slime creature. Of all the things that I could have turned into, I killed Idras and they turned into acid, or I hit Idras with slimy fight and they turned into acid blobs, but the Etin turns into a slime creature. I can now buy the chainmail. I think I'm gonna buy that. Yeah, let's go buy it. I only don't like the minus 9 mana, but that's okay. Okay, gain a bit of armor class, gain a bit of gain a bit of evasion, gain a bit of resistance to negative, and now my resistances they look very good. I wonder how much of that is coming from Jiva mutations and how much of that comes from me just having good loot. And yeah, it seems that the only thing that is actually coming from Jiva mutations is the intel is the cold resistance. I hope that I can retain this 30% HP for the rest of the game, because I definitely enjoy that. Yeah, pretty good stuff. I'm gonna try to get to a rune before I end the stream. I cannot promise anything, because it's a bit late. But I also don't wanna have that thing happen where I do D15 and I feel like the character is the greatest thing ever, and then I go into or I save for the night and I go back to, you know, streaming tomorrow. And I die like in the first fight that I get into. It's a thing that happens very frequently. And it happens even more so on melee characters, even as strong as this one, I think. Train spell casting? Yes, train spell casting is what I'm doing right now. I wanted to use Ooze Man there, because of the large amount of debuffs that I'm dealing with. Fortunately, oh, you know what? This character can probably do Elf before Alert Branch. It only needs one source of willpower, because unfortunately that's like the one thing that I haven't found, and it is relevant for that place, for Elf. Those elves have a lot of banishment, so yeah, you don't want to go there without being resistant to the banishment. Lost one stack of robust, unfortunately. Oh, you have banishment as well. 32%, jeez. Oh, the wizard is asphyxiated. I forgot that I have that mutation. That's pretty good. The Raiju is asphyxiated. Dang, Jiva is fantastic. I hope that I don't stumble into more wizards here. A buckler of fire resistance, that's an upgrade for me. I'm gonna drop this and this. And I'm gonna put this on. I'm gonna drop this. At least now I have fire resistance. 3 pips of fire resistance, 1 pip of everything else. Unfortunately, also 1 pip of willpower. Yeah, paralyzed immune. You can already get the slimy rune and the artifacts. You make a point. I should go do that. I'm gonna do it after D15. Ouch. Okay, don't kill me. What? Oh, rendered plate. Ooh, rendered plate. I hope that it's good. Yeah, I cannot run away from it because attacks of opportunity. So I'm just gonna fight it. And I'm strong enough that I can kill it. I think that's enough spell casting. Yeah, I have 7 mana. Like, Slimy Fight costs 5, Usmancy costs 3. Okay, maybe 8, just in the rare occasion that I want to do the two of those. And that's it. It's more than enough. More long blades. Ah, man, that's so disappointing. Dude, did you see that? I guess it's okay. Like, it would be too greedy for me to ask for the game to give me something apart from what I've already gotten. Well, this has been going well so far. cannot complain about what we have achieved with this character. So how is it going, Star Polemic? Sounds like it's going well for you. I legit can tell you that I wouldn't have the patience to play the Necromancer playstyle. And knowing, like, I think the big deal is knowing that I'm committed to the Necromancer playstyle because I started a Necromancer and then I went Kiku. I feel like I could do it if I started a Necromancer and I went Behemoth. That would be okay. But Necromancer of Kiku, nah. By the way, I'm petrifying here. I don't think I die, but I think I do get hurt a lot. So I'm gonna use Usmancy. Yeah, that's fine. Didn't die. That went very well. Like two different characters? Like two different characters? What do you mean by that? Oh, before and after. Yeah. Those spells are definitely not my favorite, but they are pretty useful for sure. Yeah. When I do the necromancy overview, I don't know what I'm gonna say about it. I'm just secretly hoping that all of those spells go away before I have to do the necromancy overview. Lost Cold Resistance. Got a 3 pips of fire resistance. That's completely unnecessary, you know? I already have 3 pips of fire resistance. If you want, I can write the script. I don't do those scripted. I just go there and I just talk about the spells. That's how it's always been. I need a great sword. Like a more enchanted one. Agnes. Oh, I don't like that. Might have to Usmancy her. Agnes bows, your willpower is stripped away. Fortunately, no one here hexes. The one guy that could hex me, the Death Knight, already went away. Slimeify, please. Please. She turns into a slime creature, alright. No Lage Tank, but if I had wanted to use a Lage Tank with this character, would have gone for the Lage Tank of Speed. Oh, I should have grabbed those nets. Failed to recognize them. They're like some of the rarest things that you can find in the game. I wonder if Jiva gets mad at you if you hex a jelly. I bet Jiva does get mad at you if you try to hex a jelly. Next time I see a jelly, I'm gonna try to hex it. Like I'm gonna try to aim at it with a wand of paralysis. And the game should tell me something about, hey, are you sure you want to do this? Because that's a really, really bad idea. Yeah, this attack would place you under penance. So that means that Jiva does get mad at you if you use hexes on the jellies. I'm just wondering because maybe it would be a good thing to do sometimes. Unfortunately, there's two ice dragons. That's a pretty bad thing considering that I don't have sources of cold resistance. They're actually beating the Azure Jelly. Okay, I can't kill that one ice dragon because it seriously hurt. Jikes. Usmancy? You're pretty hurt. Gonna continue tabbing. There we go, pretty nice. I'll pick up the ice scales just in case it's unfortunately my best source of cold resistance. Also gonna pick up the Orb of Gaal because as a Formicide I have nothing to fear when it comes to like 90% of the hexes. Amulet of the Air. It can go straight on the floor. The inaccuracy is actually a pretty bad property. People in the community used to like underrate how bad it was to be affected by it. But someone made calculations of how bad it actually was, and it turned out to be something crazy. I don't know the exact number, or I don't remember the exact number, but I think it was something around the lines of 50% damage reduction, just from the amount of misses that you would get if you were using the Amulet of Air, or an inaccuracy effect. I don't remember, once again, I don't remember the exact number, so I might be wildly wrong with the 50% number that I'm giving you, but I think that's how it was. So yeah, ever since then I haven't put it on. I feel like it's only good when you have a character that is a character that is using effects that do not check accuracy. That's what I wanted to say. Jellyformisid, how did this happen? I went Fated Altar on D1 and I got Jiba, and that's how it happened. And then I got an Amulet of Faith, and ever since then it's been a wild ride. This character is crazy strong already, and I am incredibly surprised at how strong it is. But of course, all things must come to an end, and so I have to go into a lure branch now. Oh no, I don't. I have to go into slime and get my piety from slime 6, or not my piety, my loot. You hear the sound of toppling stones. In case you don't know, when you go into this level, Jiba lowers the gate if you have 6 pips of piety. So Jiba will let you access all the Randars here. It's not bad, but it's also not something that I can really use with this character. You pick up the slimy rune, and now I have one rune. The hand crossbow X. Nice. That's okay. I would say that's pretty good. It doesn't give me the minus 4 strength. It doesn't give me the 9 mana compared to the other ring of 2 pips of fire resistance that I have here. Tempting, tempting for sure. I already have poison resistance. I don't care about this. It's a hand axe. For slaying, for dexterity. Yo, we're using that. Yeah, we're using that. I'm using that. I have 3 pips of fire resistance. I don't particularly care about losing my fire resistance for a bit. At least until Jiba takes it away from me, so I don't care about removing that ring, and force slaying is better than the 2 dexterity that I would have with the other ring. Not only that, but it also gives me 9 more mana, which is also a pretty nice thing. And a side of speed. All right, definitely speeds up the process of filtrating which items I want from here, which items I don't. Which I appreciate. Let's get out of here. I could go do bolts. I can go do bolts. As long as I don't stumble upon a wizard, we should be fine. I feel like I am powerful enough to. Oh, yeah, bolt sentinels. That's a good reason not to do bolts. That's definitely a good reason not to do bolts. But the alternative is lure branches, and lure branches are misery. I should enchant the greatsword. Yeah, I feel like I'm just gonna stick to it for the rest of the game. Okay, use Mancy. Oh, by the way, Makire, this is the rework of Jiba. Jiba was reworked in 0.28, I think. Jiva now gives exploration-based piety instead of giving you piety and healing and stuff, depending on the jelly seeding stuff. It's pretty nice. There is a lot of changes when it comes to Jiva, and I am very, very optimistic regarding the changes. Like, I like them a lot. Before it was Jiva was not a god that I was like particularly interested in, but now Jiva does feel like what it was always meant to be, a god that was like super strong that compensated you for going through so long in the game without having a god. No, they eat stuff. They eat stuff. They just don't eat artifacts, that's how it works. It's always worked like that. They've never eaten artifacts. Nice to be a Formicid and not have to worry about the Sphinxes. That ability that I have going on right now is a new Jiva ability. It's like Frozen Ramparts, but you can move, and it deals acid damage instead of cold damage. Pretty good ability. I like it a lot. Jiva still retains a Slimify. You still have the retaliatory jelly summon, like the Royal Jelly. And you get crazy good mutations. Parts of Jiva that were removed were the shuffling of your stats. No one liked the shuffling of your stats. Also, giving you bad mutations. I think Jiva used to give you bad mutations. Jiva also used to have an ability to remove bad mutations, but now it's no longer the case, and Jiva will just immediately try to remove bad mutations from you whenever possible. I found Crystal Plate. I might want to put it on. I'll put it on. Let's see how that goes. Doesn't seem to go very well. Yeah, I just lose a ton of evasion. Don't get anything out of that crystal plate because it's not enchanted. If I had more armor skill, it would be easier. I'm about to get Mindelei on my greatsword. Ouch. Don't do that. Stop that. I don't have cold resistance. Not having cold resistance in bolts is actually a pretty bad thing. Maybe I should have some of that. This is not going very well. Pretty good heal. Alright. Yeah, Bolt is not the greatest place for me to be in. Unfortunately, I do not have choke points. I also don't have the ability to teleport. It can be rough to be in Bolt, especially at this very low level. The only reason why I have been able to do this so far, and it's been going well, is because I have nine slaying, and I have Jiva as well. Jiva also gives you a ton of regen. So you know, used to know how you knew how Jiva used to heal you whenever jellies ate stuff. So you were kind of incentivized to carry all the stones that you could find, and then just asking for a jelly, dropping the stones and displacing the jelly for a full heal, or arrows or whatever. Now that's not a thing that you can do because Jiva gives you regen. So now I have almost two regen per turn, with no regen mutations. I have almost two regen, and Jiva can also give me the regen mutations which I had earlier. So with the regen mutations, you can hit like 4.5 regen per turn. I had 4.5 regen per turn earlier. But not anymore. The nature of the mutations that you get from Jiva is very fluctuating, but you get only good mutations. It's crazy. Also, I guess this is bad, right? Like the armor fits poorly on your massive pseudo pots. I'd like to lose this one. Somewhat reducing the amount of protection provided by body armor. No wonder the crystal plate was not doing well. Okay, that means that if I lose that, I will be able to wear the crystal plate, and it will actually give me some pretty good armor class. Still, it's unlikely for it to be better than just highly enchanted chainmail. Okay, 20 long blades. Strain for 21 fighting. Need a shield. Found a tower shield. I hope that it's still there. Spoilers, it's not gonna be there. I'll get to it once I deal with these crystal guardians. Is that multi-sapping me? I don't think it is multi-sapping me. I think it only hits me once. Yeah, that hurts. Two Crystal Guardians at the same time is pretty rough. Anyway, let's go try to find that tower shield that I unfortunately left behind accidentally, and it's not there. Oh, the pain. I have wanted a shield, like a real shield, for the longest time, and I had it, and I just didn't pick it up. That really hurts. Hopefully, I stumble upon another one soon. Your stasis prevents you from being slowed. Nice. I think they have confuse, so yeah, I need to be wary of that. Yeah, I am going to enchant my greatsword right now. Hopefully, eventually I'll get a brand weapon by the time draining, stops being so good. Right now it's good, but later on when I start seeing vampires and leeches and that kind of stuff, draining is not gonna be that good anymore. And at that point, I would like to replace it with like pretty much any other brand, except maybe for distortion. The salt food replacement thing got removed? No, salt clock is still in the game. It's just that salt clock is very, very low impact. You only see it if you do some weird things. For the vast majority of time, it's not gonna be there. Like, you're not gonna really interact with it. There was a species that got added in April 1st that was like, that had a salt clock of 1/10 of the normal species. So it was, you were forced to turn count speed run on that species. It was pretty cool. It was only for one day. It was only in trunk for one day, and it was pretty nice. But yeah, now it's pretty much gone forever unless you compile the version of the game that had it. Normally, pre-compiled versions are offered for download, but that was during like a 2 week period where there was no, where it was not being correctly backed up, and no one realized. So yeah, you have to compile if you want to play it. It was called Mayfly Tor, and I played a fair amount of it. I didn't get to pick up a rune with the Mayfly Tor. They are pretty difficult, I would say. They're strong, but they're pretty difficult. However, I do think that if you were playing a Mayfly Tor with a normal soft clock, it would be the most broken species in the game by a mile, like easily. Ouch, stop that. Okay, fortunately I do have resistance to electricity, otherwise Nikola would have exploded me there. Yeah, Nikola was not that much of an issue. I was meleeing because I was trying to get the engulfing from the mutation that I have. I have a mutation that makes me engulf living foes that are my size or smaller. Those foes will be silenced or unable to breathe. So it's like a Quicksilver Ooze melee. I was trying to do that to that guy, to Nikola, but I wasn't able to do it. Fortunately, I did kill it before that was an issue, so everything went okay. And yeah, this character is doing bolts before doing a lure branch. How I used to do it way back in the day, back when bolts was 8 levels. I never liked doing lure branches first, and of course the game has changed very drastically since, so it's not, it's barely comparable. Bolts used to be much easier back then. But yeah, it's still a thing that I like to do whenever possible, which is pretty much never, unless you are a Jiva worshipper. Because a Jiva worshipper gets access to a rune really, really fast. No, my scroll. It's fine because I know it was not a requirement. Will you take a slow fly, fire, cold, resistance, tree, slay tree ring, or plus one, rampage, fire? That sounds like an acquirement to me. I'd probably take the cloak because the cloak has willpower, but it depends on whether or not you have willpower. The ring is good, but very scary. I am leaning more towards getting the cloak, like 70% getting the cloak, 30% depending getting the ring. But at the end of the day, it really depends on the needs of your character. You would definitely want an axe if you're doing early Bolt 5 with a Phormesis. I don't think I'm doing Bolt 5. I'm doing Bolt 4 and then I'm going to, I don't know, do something else. Ideally, by then I would have some form of willpower and I would be able to, go do Elf and squeeze as much experience from the game as possible and then go do Alert Branch. Back in the day, I did used to do bolts as my first rune, but it was rare. It was not an always kind of thing. Okay, definitely don't want to be next to a wall because Frostheart. I want Oozmancy here. Yeah, this is an Oozmancy moment. Hello, Shaper. Look at this character. I'm a Phormizid of Jiva. Experience level 18 in Bolt 3. The only rune that I have picked up is the rune that I got from Jiva, like the slimy rune of Sot. I have not gone into lower branches. My character is insane. It has 9 slaying. I'm going for the dexterity. Dexterity long blades Phormizid, and I found a D1 Fated Altar, and I was like, I'm a melee character, so let's just go that. And I got Jiva, and ever since then it's been a wild ride. I've also been going at the game really, really fast. It's only been 1 hour and 15 minutes, and look at where I am right now. It really is insane. Okay, this is taking a bit to kill, but I think it did very well. Oh wow, that was a shapeshifter! And it turned into a jelly and then it stopped being hostile. Nice. I like how Jiva makes shapeshifters not be hostile. They also don't eat things, I think. Ring of Evasion. Do I care? I don't feel like I care. I'm gonna drop it. The only resistance that I'm really, really lacking is the resistance to cold. Doing this without cold resistance is very scary. Oh, also, Shaper. Earlier in the stream, I was doing like my Deep Elf Summoner, and I was about to enter Sot 5, and in the entrance of Sot 5, I got hit by an exploration trap, an exploration teleport trap, and it placed me like in the middle of, well, very close to the orb. But it placed me outside of the line of sight of the orb, and I was marked, and I was a Deep Elf, so I had like 150 HP, and I lived, and I killed everything. Those were my first casts of Shatter. It was such a cool moment, and I'm gonna put it on YouTube because it was that cool. I feel like I got rewarded for playing well there in a situation where playing poorly could have killed me, or rather, there was no guarantee that I was gonna survive regardless of playing well or not. But I feel like I did very well, yeah. So you have a 23% chance to banish me. Unfortunately, I still do not have willpower. Been losing my fire resistance too. Might have to go back to it at some point. Also, yeah, I had tower shields, but I left them on the floor. I really, really hope that I stumble upon a guy wearing a tower shield again, so I can, grab it for myself. I'm gonna need it at some point very soon. This may not have been the wisest move. I might want to. Yeah, what if we just fight this? Shatter happens, we won. I read a scroll of Fogum, and then I went for double heal wounds brilliance while hasted, and I was able to just then shatter away all the Orb Guardians, because you know how like the Orb Room is full of Orb Guardians? Well, I was very close to the Orb Room, so all those Orb Guardians just went outside and I started shattering like crazy and they just dropped dead. It was pretty good moment. Those shots where you immediately get TP trapped into the lungs. That's exactly how it was. Yeah, pretty rough. I guess I'll drink this potion of mutation. I'm a Jiva worshipper. You feel frail. You no longer feel heat resistant. Okay, though that was a pretty poor decision. Buckler of poison resistance. Buckler of poison resistance. No. I do want to have poison resistance so I can replace the ring, but I still have not found like a ring of willpower or anything. I guess I can lose the poison resistance for now. It's only gonna become relevant in Sot. Okay, we can drop the other ring. Also gonna drop the plate. I don't think I care too much about carrying a plus zero plate and this ring. At least when it comes to that ring, I know that the jellies won't eat it because it's an artifact. So if I ever feel the need to come back for it, it will be there. That's what summon scrolls are for, and mine failed. Yeah, I got some pretty bad scrolls of summon too. Like I was using them, like I would use summon butterflies back in the day, just to like create a protective barrier between me and the monsters to give myself a couple of turns to, you know, heal and haste and maybe even teleport. And yeah, they didn't go well. They didn't go well. That was pretty good situation. Pretty funny. Entertaining indeed. I'm a bit surprised that I haven't gotten banished by these wizards, let me tell you. I feel like they often just banish you. But not this time. Ouch, got agonied. Okay. The acid bluff just destroyed the frost giant, which was kind of worrisome because I lost half my HP. You feel your magical power running wild. That's pretty funny. Your body becomes viscous. What is that? I assume that is gelatinous body. Your melee attacks. No. Yeah, I think it's this one, gelatinous body. Much harder to cast, but much more powerful. If I was a spellcaster, maybe as a debuff I would be okay with that, but the vast majority of spellcasters wouldn't be okay with having 3 levels of wild magic. It's probably a lot of spell power, but yeah. But I'm not a spellcaster, I'm a melee character. I don't even have that many spells. Jellies have been eating everything. I was considering getting whoa, six slaying. And what do I lose if I put this on? Lose resistance to negative? It's probably not gonna be that bad. Yeah, I can do that. Can do that. And I can even drop it because it's an artifact. It's not gonna be eaten. So if I need the resistance to negative, I can always come back for it. Yeah, how much slaying do I have now? I feel like I should use, you know, a launcher or something. I have a manual of crossbows. Okay, that settles it. Pick up this arbalest. At the end of the day, I am a Phormicid, so I can use two-handers and shields at the same time. That's a lot of dudes right there. I don't know what's going on. Blessed run. Yes, blessed run. That is correct. Usmancy. Not a fan of the Simulacra, of course. They can deal a lot of damage. Jiva gives you passive resistance to corrosion, right? I think that's how it is. Oh, hold on. I can make sure of that by pressing this button right here. Yes, Jiva protects you from corrosive effects. Okay. This character is so insane, dude. Look at that. I was marked as a Formiseed, and I didn't feel like running away. And I just killed everything. Okay, your Quicksilver Ooze hits the Necromancer. Just destroy the Necromancer that agonied me. If you were wondering why I just lost all of that HP all of a sudden, that's because I got agonied. The one thing that this character doesn't have is willpower. Yes, I would like to have willpower and cold resistance. Yeah, those would be nice. At some point on this character, I have 3 pips of fire resistance. I have 2 pips of cold resistance, and I had 3 robust as well. Robust 3. Of course, I already lost pretty much all of that. Hopefully, at some point, I'll get back at least half of those things. I would also like to have a tower shield. Yeah. Lots of shields, none that I truly care about. At least a kite shield would be nice. Okay. I think I got shafted. No idea. I think I did get shafted, but I went upstairs or something. Okay, I think we're done with bolts. I think that's where I'm gonna leave it for the night. Thank you for watching and thank you for hanging out. If you enjoyed what you saw, you should consider following if you're not already following. And if you are, you can consider subscribing. You don't have to, and I understand if you don't want to or you can't, but it does help me if you choose to do so. With that being said, I will be back tomorrow. This character is incredibly powerful already. It has so much slaying. It has, let's see. Six, 11, 15 slaying. Of course, it's 15 slaying on a great sword, so it's not as good as 15 slaying on a quick blade, but it is still 15 slaying. No character is gonna say no to 15 slaying. It is a bit lacking in the resistances department, and of course, I don't think I'm ever gonna be able to fully enchant any piece of weapon or armor because Worshipper of Jiva, but at least it's been going quite well. Yeah, it's been really, really strong. It doesn't really have much that it really can do, but what it can do, it does it pretty well. Also, I have a manual of crossbows, and I have 15 slaying, so yeah, I better put that into use. That's gonna be really good for the end game. Even more so if I somehow find damnation. But yeah, that's gonna be it for me tonight. I'll come back tomorrow, and it's gonna be fun. So yeah, you can look forward to that. For now, let's go raid the sumo stream.